What's up, Gamer Tag Nation? Today we are going inside Xbox Live. So pretty much what's going to happen is we're going to take a deep dive into yesterday's Xbox Live event. We're going to be starting off with some Obsidian, and then we're going to take a look at the Xbox Series X, going into some other games for Xbox, and we are going to talk about a little bit what to expect of the coming months. So let's take a look. So first we're going to take a look at Xbox's new game, which comes to Steam and Early Access on July 28th. It is developed by Obsidian Entertainment.
At Obsidian, we're really well known for creating awesome storylines. And with Grounded, we want to expand on how we tell stories. So I've always wanted to make a survival game. And one thing that we're doing with Grounded is playing a lot of survival games and looking at the genre as a whole to see where we can improve. First, we have environmental storytelling. So we want to tell the story through the places that you're visiting and do it through the artwork and the atmosphere, the areas that you're exploring. It's all handcrafted. We spend a lot of time talking about the tiny little details of why is this thing in the yard in the first place, who put it here, depending on the materials that the things are made out of, how they're placed, what's the purpose of this thing. We want to make all these details where it's actually a place that feels lived in and it feels alive.
First things first, you're not supposed to be here.
So in the trailer, you've heard a voice, and that's our robot buddy, Burgle. Burgle is your buddy and your pal, and he guides you through the adventure, and he's also just the NPC that you can talk to if you get lost, if you need some help.
You'll either be fine, or you will be dead. It's really up to you.
In the trailer, you notice that we do hint at that there's something else going on in the yard, and we do have a secrets and layers to discover. So there is some evil force in the yard, and you'll discover who they are and what they're up to throughout the story and the adventure. In Grounded, not only can you play in multiplayer, and it's a great multiplayer experience, but you can also play in single player. We want to support all different types of players. So if you want to be the player who crafts armor and armors up and goes through the adventure, you can do that. If you want to play a stealthy player, you can do that. If you want to just go destroy everything and build up a arsenal of weaponry, you can do that as well. What's really exciting to me is that this is just the start of the journey. So when we launch in game preview, the storyline's not going to be finished. I have tons of ideas. I know the team has tons of ideas. I'm sure the community will have tons of ideas on how to make this game the best game that it can possibly be. So let us know how you feel about it, what you're jazzed about, and we'll work with you and work with the community to see where the storyline goes from here.
Grounded looks like a fun, definitely fun exploration. Wow, didn't realize that was going to happen. Grounded looks like a fun, definitely fun exploration game. Obsidian Entertainment is known for Fallout New Vegas and South Park The Stick of Truth. Back in November of 2018, Microsoft announced that Obsidian would become part of the Xbox Game Studios. So this is their first look at the game, which is awesome. Moving on to next generation of consoles, which are slated to come out later this year, hopefully production permitting. But let's take a look inside of the Xbox Series X.
Joining us today is Jason Ronald, who's the Director of Program Management for Xbox Series X. Jason, great to see you.
Great to see you too, Larry.
Now, we had a lot of news recently about Xbox Series X. We talked about a lot of different things. Can you kind of go over quickly what they were?
Sure. So it was an exciting time because we finally revealed the full technical specifications of the Xbox Series X and provided insight into some of the key innovations powering the next generation of gaming. Xbox Series X is our fastest, most powerful console ever, powered by our custom designed processor built in partnership with AMD, leveraging the latest RDNA 2 and Zen 2 architectures. And we really designed the system to deliver consistent, sustained performance never seen before in a game console. And we really designed it to have the optimal speed balance of power and speed in console design. And it's ultimately about enabling transformative gaming experiences you've never seen before in the living room.
Now, we heard about things like ray tracing and variable rate shading. What does that mean for gamers?
So ray tracing has always been the holy grail of computer graphics. But we've never had the power to actually do it in real time. So we added a custom hardware to be able to do hardware-accelerated DirectX ray tracing, which is really about delivering higher fidelity visuals, more immersive environments, things like better lighting, shadows, reflections off water and glass. And you can use the exact same techniques for 3D spatial audio so that you get a much more immersive experience. You mentioned variable rate shading. Variable rate shading is really about delivering new levels of performance and efficiency to developers so that they can go well beyond the raw power of the box itself, because they can be more precise about where they choose to spend graphics power in different parts of the scene without reducing the overall visual quality. And then on the audio side, we developed a custom hardware audio block so that we could actually offload that work from the CPU. And that means that you're going to get a much richer audio experience. But because we've offloaded it from the CPU, that means you're going to have more complex AI, better animation, more denser, richer worlds. Then you look at something like Quick Resume. Quick Resume is actually built on top of the Xbox Velocity architecture, which actually just really allows players to jump in and jump out of experiences very quickly and pick up exactly where they left off. And, you know, as somebody who's been using this for the last couple months, it's really transformed how I actually play games. And it's just, it's such a great experience. And to be honest, it's really hard to go back and play games without using these new capabilities that the new hardware is enabling.
All right, I've heard this thing called Xbox Velocity Architecture. What is that and what is it going to mean to gamers?
The Xbox Velocity Architecture is really defined by four major components. First is the custom designed NVMe SSD, and it's going to deliver levels of performance you've never seen in console gaming before. The next is we have a dedicated hardware decompression block so that we can take those assets and expand them so that developers have direct access to them in real time so that you get much more dense worlds, richer textures, you know, more dynamic environments. The next thing is we actually have a new member of the DirectX family called Direct Storage, which is a brand new API that gives developers direct low-level access to the NVMe controller. And then finally, we have a new feature called Sampler Feedback Streaming, which actually allows developers to, on demand, request data from the solid-state storage drive, and that acts as a memory multiplier. So when you think about these large open-world games like a Red Dead Redemption 2 or an Assassin's Creed Odyssey, we wanted the technology to fade into the background so that players just get that really rich, dynamic, immersive environment, unlike what you've ever seen in previous generations.
Jason, can you tell us a little bit more about the storage options available for Xbox Series X, including what this is?
Sure. So what you just held up was the 1 terabyte Seagate storage expansion card for Xbox Series X that we've developed in partnership with Seagate. And that matches the internal performance exactly. And it's all about sustained performance. So if a game takes full advantage of the Xbox Velocity architecture, that same game can live on the internal storage or can live on that external expandable storage card, and you'll get the exact same performance. But at the same time, too, we know plenty of people have existing USB hard drives, and we want to make it as easy as possible. So you can easily just take the existing external hard drive that you have, unplug it from your current console, plug it into your Xbox Series X, and all your games are instantly available to you. And you can continue to run all those games directly off that external drive. So once again, we're really focused on giving as many options as possible because we know storage is critically important for gamers who have plenty of games that they love playing.
Thanks, Jason. Now I want to be super clear about what Jason just said. You can always take your Xbox One games and play them directly off your external hard drive when connected to Xbox Series X. Now for Xbox Series X games, you can certainly store them on your external hard drive, but when you're ready to play them, you're going to want to move them to the internal SSD or the Seagate expansion drive right here. It's that simple.
Anything else you'd like to share before I let you go?
Honestly, from the team, we're just really excited to get this out into players' hands later this year. You know, we're going to be delivering four generations of content. Thousands of games will be available on day one. And we're really excited by what developers are doing right now to build new games for the Xbox Series X. So we're excited to ship it later this year.
Jason Ronald, Director of Program Management for Xbox Series X, thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much, Larry.
Big thing this generation is definitely going to be that ray tracing, which allows for lack of loading times, which is going to be amazing for definitely open world games, games that have struggled in the past with large loading screens. So hopefully maybe games like Call of Duty, you can just go right into the action instead of sitting there for 30 to 40 seconds waiting for the whole game to load. The weird thing about the Xbox is that they are kind of bringing proprietary save or hard drives back, which is kind of interesting. They still haven't talked about the price point of them. How much are they going to be? The price point is a big deal because if we look at past generations of consoles, including the PlayStation Vita, which definitely died because of their proprietary cartridges. So looking into that, hopefully they won't be too expensive, but I'm going to assume that that 1 terabyte hard drive is probably going to be around $100. Xbox did also announce a few games coming to Xbox Game Pass. So Football Manager 2020, Journey to the Savage Planet, and more are coming to Xbox Game Pass this April. However, the highlight had to be Yakuza Kiwami, the beginning of the popular franchise, which is coming to the service at a later date. They didn't specify. Hopefully it's towards the end of April or maybe the beginning of May.
Gears Tactics was developed by a small, passionate team of strategy game lovers. It's a single-player campaign experience that broadens the Gears of War franchise. Here are five badass things that you should know about Gears Tactics.
Okay, cupcakes, listen up.
Gears Tactics was built from the ground up for the PC. While it is a turn-based game, we did a lot to make it fast-paced. We serve you a lot of enemies per encounter, and we give you a free action system. So you have three actions per unit that you can use to move, shoot, or apply your skills as you want. So there's a lot of things to shoot at. In Gears Tactics, the main character is Gabe Diaz. Gabe is a reluctant leader who's found himself in the motor pool due to circumstances beyond his control, and he's pressed back into service because of the emerging monster's threat coming from underground. If the name sounds familiar, he is in fact Kate's dad, Kate being the main character from Gears 5.
Just like you planned it.
In Gears Tactics, Gabe is on the hunt for an evil locust named Ukon.
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 Now, Ukon is a geneticist. He's the monster that makes monsters. The Corpsers and Brumox, the big bosses that you see in Gears of War, that's Ukon's handiwork. Executions will keep you in the fight. Gears of War has always featured these incredible executions that you can do with the Lancer, Assault Rifle, or the Nasher Shotgun. But in Gears Tactics, executions have a strategic value.
How is that even possible?
If you run forward and execute an enemy, it will actually grant bonus actions to the entire squad. This means you can keep moving forward and keep your momentum. In addition, everything in the game is earnable. There'll be no loot boxes, no microtransactions, and what you see, you can earn. Gears Tactics is full of customization options. There are five different classes in the game, each with 30 or more skills, lots of combinations of things to find as you level up. Each class has a primary weapon. Each weapon has five mod slots, so you can improve the scopes or improve the barrels. All this together creates a bunch of combinations so you can try to win the way you want to win. In Gears Tactics, we also have a cosmetic customization system. Each soldier has three slots, the helmet slot, the torso slot, and the leg slot. Each can be uniquely configured, so different colors and patterns and metallic finishes. So if you want to go into the fight against Dukan with multicolored leopard print pants, you can totally do that. There you have it, five badass things about Gears Tactics. Gears Tactics went gold today. You can pre-order now to play on Steam or Windows 10, and it's included in Xbox Game Pass for PC. Watch for it on Xbox consoles later this year.
Gears Tactics definitely looks like a good game. I would probably prefer it on PC just because it seems like it's more of a keyboard and mouse game. The game does look bloody fantastic, and I do mean all the puns there because it looked like there was a lot of gore, kind of reminiscent to all that blood from Doom that you would see, or maybe even Mortal Kombat type of violence. Microsoft also announced some games for Project X Cloud. It's expanding to Japan and other territories, and it's also getting new games like Dragon Age Inquisition Unravel 2 and The Sims 4. There's also a cute little game that Microsoft has announced. It's called The Last Campfire. So let's take a look.
Hi everyone, I'm Steven Burgess, the designer on The Last Campfire, and I'd like to show you an Xbox One exclusive of a couple of moments taken from the first minutes of the game.
Our story begins in the dark, in a hopeless place where a lost ember sleeps.
This is really exciting for me, actually. We've been working on this game for a few years, and it's really nice to be able to show other people what we're working on. This is Ember, and somehow they've become lost.
Ember ran without hesitation. The wall glistened in the light. The painting glowed, reacting to Ember's presence. It showed a moment from the first Ember story. Ember just hoped it would show the way home.
What you're seeing now is the narrator. She follows you through the game and fills out some of the backstory as you're traveling and reacts to your actions.
It was a relief to find someone else, but the stranger was deathly still.
Hopefully you can see that the world looks quite charming, but you'll feel that there's a real undercurrent of darkness. That's what we're trying to get across.
Ember froze, almost too frightened to look away, when they noticed a small satchel.
I think this kind of charming dark fantasy is something you don't really see that often in games. I really love this moment with Ember. It's the first time Ember's seen a skeleton. Despite that, Ember's first thought is empathy. A little touch on the shoulder to say sorry and pay respect.
The satchel felt heavy. Ember looked inside. Inside was a gold statue molded in the likeness of the first Ember. On the floor was the symbol of a campfire.
We've taken a lot of different inspirations for making the game. Illustrate books and movies like The Dark Crystal or Labyrinth.
Something about the door felt wrong.
And we really wanted to tell a story that would fit in that style. And just like those stories, there's hints that as you play, this won't always be a happy tale. Moments like this are down to our artist, Chris Simons. He's our entire art team. Just one man has made all the art and animation that you can see.
Ember departed, thinking only of the stranger, now left in the dark.
He's put so many beautiful little touches and moments in, I think people really enjoy just taking in all the scenery as they're wandering around.
The stairway led to an unfamiliar forest. If the stories of the first Ember were true, a path through the forest would lead to the campfire.
Sometimes I'm playing a new build, and I'm used to seeing this white box layout and I'm taken aback. He's transformed it completely with so much love.
The flame called out to Ember. Ember tried to listen.
So the cage you see ahead there is a place where hope has become trapped.
The flame was almost within reach.
We wanted the interactions to feel really tactile. You don't just press a button, you're pulling on a lever or tugging at the chain.
The flame spoke and Ember listened.
This tactile feel becomes really important and a big part of the game later on. Most games with puzzles tend to have a format of a series of increasingly difficult versions of the same puzzle. But for Campfire, we were trying to make it so that each puzzle you encounter feels new or has a unique twist. It's almost like a smorgasbord of all different types of logic puzzles. Like here, as you step out into the forest for the first time. It's a welcome relief to be outside, but then you kind of realise that this forest still might not be safe. And I think they're just understanding that this place they're trapped in is a dangerous one and they might never escape. Finding and rekindling hope is actually one of the big themes at the heart of the game. And learning to appreciate just how fragile that hope can be.
As the forlorn ember awoke, the campfire flickered into life.
Well, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the sneak peek.
The Last Campfire is the next game from No Man's Sky developer Hello Games. It definitely looks like a cute and charming game, especially for your wee little tots. Now, Microsoft did also announce some PC news. Xbox Game Bar on PC will support third-party widgets, including tools like XSplit. This is an incredibly useful development that should help streamers connect their games easier. Now, our final note for today in the Xbox Inside is a new update to Sea of Thieves.
Sharpen your cutlass and get ready for battle with Sea of Thieves and our next monthly update, Ships of Fortune. The trading companies of the Sea of Thieves want you to join their cause by signing up to become an emissary. Working on their behalf will see you rewarded with exclusive cosmetics and help you to progress in the newly expanded reputation system. You can join any of the existing trading companies, as well as the newly established Reaper's Bones. This sinister lot are all about battle and bloodshed, and would like nothing more than for you to burn the other emissaries to the ground. And in the arena, our explosive competitive mode, we've overhauled your matches to make them even more action-packed. The old treasure maps are gone, now replaced by a single chest marked by a Sea Dog beacon. With only one cash-in location, you'll have to battle hard to secure victory. And there's no time to waste either, with each contest now slashed from 24 to 15 minutes. Whether you're fighting for glory in the arena, or battling for loot and adventure, if you find yourself on the wrong end of a blunderbuss, your crew will now have a brief window to revive you and bring you back into the fight. And that's not all. Over in the Pirate Emporium, we've got fancy new emotes. A stunning Saberwolf-inspired ship set. And the introduction of cats. These furry felines will follow you in adventures across the seas. You know, except for when you're sleeping. Cats are like. So get ready to choose your side in the next Sea of Thieves monthly update, Ships of Fortune.
Ships of Fortune for Sea of Thieves does launch April 22nd. So all of you pirates out there, get your ships and remember, scrub the poop deck. No one wants a dirty poop deck. Where has come a long way since its 007 days on the N64, so it's definitely interesting to see how they did with an MMO style game that's a little bit more cartoony. Now, that was Xbox Inside. What was your thoughts? I am really digging the new Grounded game. It looks pretty awesome and it looks hilarious. Definitely a fun game. We are always looking forward to new next-gen news, especially with Xbox Series X and PS5 launching sometime this year, most likely around November. That seems to be the sweet spot. And Gears of War, or Gears Tactics, looks bloody amazing. Again, I just had to say that. It looks really good. So, for up-to-date news, make sure you go to gamertagnews.weebly.com. Definitely give us a like and follow on Facebook and Twitter.
I love that part.